how a 700-year-old water system still outsmarts modern technology. While other Muslim strongholds across Spain fell to Christian forces during the Reconquista, Granada stood defiant. For two full centuries after its neighbors surrendered, Granada remained unconquered. What made this final bastion of Islamic Spain so resilient? The answer lies largely in its crown jewel. By the end of this video, you'll discover how medieval engineers created a water system so sophisticated they could make fountains dance, power clocks, and heat floors, all without electricity or modern pumps. We'll reveal exactly how they transformed their biggest vulnerability, a lack of water on a hilltop, into their greatest strength. The Alhambra sits perched high atop a hill overlooking Granada, providing clear military advantages against potential invaders. Any attacking force would need to fight uphill against defenders who could see them approaching from miles away. But this strategic elevation created an enormous engineering challenge. How do you supply abundant water to a hilltop palace in medieval times? This wasn't just about basic survival needs. The Islamic rulers of Granada envisioned something far more ambitious. A paradise on earth with flourishing fountains, lush gardens, and luxurious baths, all requiring tremendous amounts of water. Imagine the problem they faced. The nearby Daro River flows far below the palace. Without modern pumps or electricity, how could medieval engineers possibly move enough water uphill to create their vision? The solution they devised revealed an astonishing level of ingenuity that continues to impress engineers today. They constructed the Acequia Real, the Royal Canal, a 6-kilometer masterpiece of precision engineering that begins at a higher elevation in the mountains, then gradually slopes toward the Alhambra with an incredibly shallow gradient. This canal represents medieval engineering at its finest. Think about the mathematical precision required to calculate a slope gentle enough to prevent destructive water velocity, yet steep enough to maintain flow. How did they achieve such accuracy without modern surveying equipment? The canal required careful integration with the natural terrain, using gravity itself as the driving force to deliver water to the palace. In some sections, the grade is so subtle that water appears to be flowing uphill, an optical illusion that must have seemed magical to visitors of that era. Once water reached the palace grounds, the engineers faced another challenge: consistent water pressure. Their solution was a massive high-level storage pool capable of holding approximately 400 cubic meters of water. This reservoir served multiple purposes, creating reliable water pressure for fountains and features throughout the complex, providing backup supply during droughts, and offering strategic reserves in case of a siege. Have you ever considered how vulnerable a hilltop fortress becomes when enemies cut off its water supply? The Alhambra's designers certainly did, transforming what could have been a weakness into one of its greatest strengths. Water within the Alhambra wasn't merely functional, it was deeply symbolic. Control over abundant water in arid Spain represented absolute power. When Christian diplomats or foreign dignitaries visited, they encountered not a dry, austere fortress, but a paradise where water flowed seemingly without limitation. The psychological impact cannot be overstated. How could you not be intimidated by rulers who commanded the very elements? This wasn't just engineering. It was political theater of the highest order. The initial distribution system from the main reservoir was a complex network of ceramic pipes, open channels, and hidden conduits. Some pipes were embedded within walls, others ran beneath floors, creating a circulatory system that brought life to every corner of the palace complex. The designers had to account for differences in elevation throughout the sprawling grounds, ensuring appropriate water pressure for each feature. They created smaller intermediary pools at strategic locations, employed narrowing pipes to increase pressure where needed, and installed clever overflow systems to prevent damage during heavy rainfall. What makes all of this even more remarkable is the philosophy behind it. The Nasrid engineers balanced pragmatic needs with ambitious vision, scientific precision with artistic expression. Their approach wasn't simply about solving problems, it was about creating harmony between natural elements and human design. They understood that water has its own properties and behaviors that cannot be forced, only guided. This respect for natural principles resulted in systems so well conceived that many continue functioning after 7 centuries. When you wander through the Alhambra today, much of this engineering mastery remains hidden from view. The visible water features, the reflecting pools, the fountains, the peaceful channels, represent just the surface of a much deeper technological achievement. But understanding the challenges these medieval engineers overcame gives us a new appreciation for what we're seeing. How did they develop such advanced hydraulic understanding without modern science? What processes of trial and error led to these sophisticated solutions? These questions make the Alhambra not just a beautiful historic site, but one of history's most impressive engineering achievements. The true genius of the Alhambra's water system becomes apparent when examining its specific technological innovations. Among these, perhaps most impressive, is what modern engineers call the defiant gravity water lifting device. Located in the western portion of the palace, this remarkable invention raised water an additional 6 meters higher without using any external power source. No water wheels, no animals, just clever manipulation of physical principles. So, how does it work? The engineers created a container with a whirlpool effect that generated a low-pressure zone, essentially sucking air downward into a lower vessel. This air mixed with water in a thin pipe, creating a lighter water-air mixture that could travel upward against gravity. This principle, which anticipates modern fluid dynamics, demonstrates an understanding of physics that seems impossible for the 14th century. Throughout the complex, the designers employed multiple water lifting methods depending on specific needs and locations. In some areas, traditional water wheels turned by animal power raised water to intermediate levels. These mechanical solutions were strategically positioned to maximize efficiency while remaining hidden from the palace's elegant spaces. The engineers understood that different problems required different solutions. There was no one-size-fits-all approach to water management in the Alhambra. Perhaps the most captivating feature was the time-telling Fountain of Lions. This 14th century marvel functioned as a water clock, with each of its 12 marble lions spouting water in sequence to mark the hours. How could such precision timing be achieved with medieval technology? The secret lay in a masterfully designed system with 12 holes placed at specific heights within a central bowl. As water continuously flowed into this bowl at a carefully regulated rate, it could reach each hole in sequence, activating the corresponding lion's water jet. By midday, all 12 lions would be spouting water. Then, a clever siphon mechanism inside the bowl would automatically reset the system for the next 12-hour cycle. This represents hydrological engineering of remarkable sophistication, combining mathematical precision with artistic expression. The calculations required for this fountain alone are staggering. Engineers needed to determine the exact flow rate, the precise height of each hole, and the specific dimensions of the siphon, all without modern measuring tools or fluid dynamics equations. The margin for error was minuscule. Even small miscalculations would throw off the entire timing system. Yet, they achieved such precision that the fountain functioned reliably for centuries. But before we continue discussing this hydraulic wonder, don't forget to like this video, subscribe if you haven't, and if you have any thoughts about this water technological marvel, leave them in the comments down below. The thermal baths within the Alhambra represented another engineering triumph. The complex included three distinct chambers, a cold plunge pool, a heated room with warm floors, and a steam room. The system began with a copper boiler heated by burning wood. From the central heat source, hot water circulated to the baths, while steam was directed through channels beneath the flooring, creating what we would now recognize as radiant heating. The engineers even designed hollow columns that allowed steam to travel upward and exit through vents, filling the steam room with vapor. Above this room, star-shaped windows in the ceiling controlled the amount of steam that escaped, maintaining ideal conditions. This sophisticated climate control system predated modern HVAC concepts by centuries. These thermal features weren't just for comfort. They served important religious and cultural functions, as ritual purification was central to Islamic practice. The engineers had to ensure consistent temperatures, appropriate humidity levels, and adequate ventilation throughout the complex. They achieved this through careful attention to thermal properties of materials and thoughtful distribution of heat sources. Throughout the palace, the designers employed evaporative cooling techniques to naturally air-condition spaces. In the hot, dry climate of Granada, water features were positioned to maximize cooling effects as breezes passed over them. This created pockets of cooler air that circulated through rooms and courtyards, significantly lowering temperatures during summer months. The strategic positioning of fountains, channels, and pools wasn't just aesthetically pleasing, it was functionally crucial for thermal regulation. What makes these technologies truly remarkable is their integration. Each element worked in harmony with others, creating a holistic system that addressed multiple needs simultaneously. Water that supplied fountains could later irrigate gardens. Overflow from decorative pools fed functional channels. Nothing was wasted, and every drop served multiple purposes before eventually returning to the land. This cyclic approach demonstrates an environmental awareness that feels surprisingly modern, challenging our assumptions about historical attitudes towards resource management. Throughout the Alhambra, the line between engineering and art completely disappears. Every functional element was transformed into something beautiful, while seemingly decorative features often concealed practical purposes. This brilliant duality reaches its pinnacle in the Court of the Myrtles, where a vast reflecting pool creates a mirror image of the surrounding architecture. The pool serves multiple functions simultaneously. It provides water storage, cools the surrounding area through evaporation, creates stunning visual effects through reflection, and produces soothing acoustic properties as water gently ripples from small fountains at either end. The sound engineering aspects are particularly fascinating. The architects understood how water generates different sounds depending how it flows, falls, or bubbles. They deliberately designed features to create specific acoustic environments, from the gentle murmur of shallow channels to the meditative splashing of fountains. These sounds weren't random. They were carefully orchestrated to enhance the sensory experience of each space. In some areas, water sounds masked conversations for privacy. In others, they amplified the feeling of coolness during hot summer months. Moving beyond the main palace to the Generalife Gardens, we discover another dimension of water mastery. Here, the aesthetic beauty merges with agricultural innovation in terraced gardens that once produced food for the palace. The same water that created beauty also ensured survival, flowing through an intricate network of irrigation channels called acequias. These narrow waterways could be blocked or opened using simple wooden gates, allowing gardeners to direct water precisely where needed. The system was so efficient that it maintained lush vegetation despite the region's hot, dry summers. These gardens embody core Islamic principles about humanity's relationship with nature. Water in Islamic tradition represents divine mercy, life-giving, purifying, and precious. The garden designers created spaces that celebrated water's sacred qualities while demonstrating responsible stewardship of this resource. The four-part division seen in many of the garden spaces directly references the Quranic description of paradise with four flowing rivers. By recreating this divine pattern, these builders weren't just making something beautiful, they were creating spaces for spiritual contemplation and connection. The mathematical precision underlying these water features reveals another level of sophistication. Flow rates had to be calculated exactly, water pressure predicted accurately, and distribution systems balanced perfectly. The engineers understood concepts like fluid dynamics, hydrostatic pressure, and the effects of gravity on water movement. They worked with these principles to create effects that seemed magical, but were actually based on solid scientific understanding. The calculations had to account for several variations in water supply, evaporation rates during hot periods, and potential blockages from mineral buildup. Perhaps most impressive is how these systems have survived for centuries. The original engineers built redundancy into their designs, anticipating potential failures and creating alternative pathways for water flow. They selected durable materials that could withstand constant water exposure without rapid deterioration. They designed components that could be easily accessed and repaired when necessary. This forward-thinking approach to maintenance ensured that the systems could function across generations, surviving political changes, natural disasters, and the simple passage of time. Modern engineers studying the Alhambra continue to discover valuable lessons about sustainable water management. The passive cooling techniques, gravity-powered distribution, and efficient irrigation methods offer insights for contemporary green building practices. The multi-use approach to water, where some water serves decorative, practical, and agricultural purposes before returning to the environment, demonstrates a circular resource model that today's sustainability experts advocate. How many modern buildings can claim to have water systems that would function for seven centuries with minimal technological intervention? The living legacy of Alhambra's water engineering extends beyond its own walls. Its techniques influenced water management throughout Spain following the Reconquista, as Christian rulers recognized the superiority of these Islamic systems. Elements of its design spread throughout Europe during the Renaissance, shaping how water would be used in gardens and buildings for centuries to come. Even today, when visitors from around the world experience the Alhambra's water features, they're connecting with an engineering tradition that has shaped our understanding of how to create harmony between built environments and natural resources. What makes all this truly remarkable is that many of these water features still function today, nearly 700 years after their creation. While some components may have been restored or replaced over the centuries, the fundamental systems remain largely intact. The original design was so excellent, so forward-thinking, that it continues to operate despite the enormous technological and social changes that have occurred since its creation. Few human achievements demonstrate such extraordinary durability. I hope you've enjoyed this exploration of the Alhambra's incredible water engineering. How different our world might be if we hadn't lost so much ancient and medieval knowledge during periods of political upheaval. What other technological marvels might have developed if the scientific traditions of Islamic Spain had continued uninterrupted? Let us know your thoughts in the comments and be sure to check out our next videos on the screen right now.